Hey everybody, Dr. Cranky here in the Lab-RAT-ory. Another episode of putting together old borax, which is coming along slow, but you know, we're taking our time and doing it right, the way we like to do it these days. Lots and lots of parts, but we are slowly making our way through it. But this video is not about the parts. This video, I wanted to talk a little bit about instructions, which look like that, of course, for this build. And the reason why I'm showing you the instructions is, of course, I had not seen them. I have yet to build a full kit of this 57 Ford. And so, you know, I thought, okay, let me do a video on what to do with these. Now, whether you are new or a seasoned veteran of model building, the one thing you never do, of course, is you never throw out your instructions. You also don't ignore your instructions. Revell, for example, has gone out of its way to make its instructions very clear, but also have it be not only a guide, which gives you a little bit of history, but also, you know, it gives you a parts list, which is very important if you are missing a part and you plan to call them for part replacement. This part, of course, is the painting guide, which I often do not follow. I mean, unless you're going for box stock and also for exactly the model that's on the cover, most of us, I would say, don't pay that much attention to it. Although for paint choices, you can begin there. There's nothing wrong with it. So what we do normally is we spend a little bit of time studying the instructions, making sure that all the parts are accounted for. We also start choosing what kind of engine we are going to put on this, whether it's going to be the stock engine or the drag engine, which also you can think about. And so in our case, we're going with the stock engine. This is just going to be a simple, fairly box stock build, except for the, of course, a few parts that we've added. There is the suspension, the rear suspension, front suspension, the engine, the gas. So you begin to see how slowly but surely, step by step, you can get this model built. And most of the time, I will keep this handy. I have a piece of glass underneath the my work surface that I put this under, so that even when I'm not looking at it, it's still there for easy reference. Of course, toward the end here, beyond step 8, say, you start getting instructions on how to apply the decals to the interior, which we are not using. You know, final assembly comes up very quickly in this kit, in part because it doesn't have that many parts, say, in the interior. So, but you know, it's a wonderful kit. We are having fun building it, and we are looking forward to having a kit that, of course, a model that is completely different than anybody else's model, which is always what we do here in the Lab-RAT-ory. So, but I think it's going to build. This is the drag version that would take all the wonderful decals that come with it. So definitely, you know, don't throw out your parts. Keep the information handy, and keep your spare parts handy for another project later on. So we are very excited to get going on this finally, and we've been doing some work. We've added mesh for the back window there, and we've with our Sharpie we masked and we've gone around the windshield to paint the frame instead of foiling it. We kind of like doing that because it's a lot, you know, milder and more in scale, so we didn't use foil this time. And so we're slowly working on the chassis, and I'll walk you through a few other things that that we're doing to weather this beauty. So old borax is coming together very well, and we're looking forward to it. And as you can see, we're putting these handy trays that we got for dirt cheap not so long ago to good work. Oh, and remember, the bed is now completely glued. It hasn't been finished yet in terms of weathering, but it's the planks are glued in, and all it's missing is a little bit of dirt and some of the usual detailing that we provide here in the Lab-RAT-ory. So, all right, my friends, just a quick little update. I hope you will stay tuned in for more Cranky Show coming your way.